Good morning everyone. This video is for class 7 and the subject is science. The topic is heat and temperature. First of all, let us get to know what are hot and cold objects. See the pictures. See on the left side, suppose this glass has cold water. When you drink cold water, your taste buds tell that it is cold. On the right side is hot coffee. Suppose you are drinking hot coffee, then you get to know that it is hot. Now see this ice cube. If we take this ice cube and put it on the palm of our hand, we can feel that it is very cold. If we sit next to the fire, then we can feel the warmth of the fire, and so we know that the fire is warm or it is hot. Now see the picture of this ice cream. After eating this ice cream, you will come to know that it is very cold. But in all these pictures that we had seen, we can only tell that something is hot or hotter, cold or colder. We cannot tell the accurate temperature of all these objects. So how will we get the correct temperature? How can we get an accurate idea about the degree of hotness or coldness? Now see, we can get the accurate idea with the help of temperature. Temperature of an object gives us an accurate idea about the degree of hotness or coldness of an object. So what is temperature? Temperature is defined as the measure of the degree of hotness or coldness of an object. Now in order to calculate the temperature, we need a scale. So, a temperature scale is used to measure temperature quantitatively and accurately. Every temperature scale has an upper fixed point and a lower fixed point. The length between the two fixed points is divided into a number of equal divisions, each called degree. This will be better be explained with the help of a diagram. Look at the two diagrams. In the left side diagram, it is the diagram of a Celsius thermometer in which a Celsius scale is used. Here, 100 degrees Celsius is the point at which water boils. 0 degree is the point at which water freezes. And 37 degrees Celsius is the normal body temperature. On the right side is the Fahrenheit thermometer having a Fahrenheit scale. The 212 degree Fahrenheit is the point at which water boils, and 32 degree Fahrenheit is the point at which water freezes, and in Fahrenheit the normal body temperature is 98.6 degree Fahrenheit. There are two common scales, Celsius scale and Fahrenheit scale, as you have seen just now. This Celsius scale is measured in degrees Celsius, and the scale is divided into 100 equal divisions, whereas this Fahrenheit scale is measured in degree Fahrenheit, and the scale is divided into 180 equal divisions. Now the Celsius scale and the Fahrenheit scale can be interconverted. If you only know the Celsius scale and you want to know the Fahrenheit scale, you can use this formula. C is equal to 5 by 9, F minus 32 is in bracket. Or you want to find out the Fahrenheit scale, they can use the formula 9 by 5 C plus 32. Let's see for example. Convert 40 degrees Celsius into degree Fahrenheit. First of all, what we will do, we will write C, that is the Celsius, is equal to 42 degree. F, that is Fahrenheit, that is what we have to find out. And the formula to find out F is 9 divided by 5 C plus 32. Now we'll put the numbers in the formula. We will get F is equal to 9 by 5 in bracket 42 plus 32. After calculation, we will find out 75.6 plus 32 is equal to 107.6. So the answer is 42 degrees Celsius is equal to 107.6 degree Fahrenheit. In the same way, we can calculate the centigrade also using the formula. Now, in order to measure temperature of an object, we need a thermometer. So, a thermometer is an instrument used to measure temperature of an object. And on this thermometer, the scales are used. The common types of thermometer are clinical thermometer, digital thermometer, and laboratory thermometer. In this picture given here, first of all, the clinical thermometer is shown. Now you can see on the left side, this is the diagram of the clinical thermometer. This thermometer is made up of a uniform glass tube. At one side, on the left side, is a glass, small glass bulb, which is filled with mercury, and on the right side, this glass tube is sealed. Now just above the glass bulb is a kink. This kink means a little bend in the glass tube, so that the mercury level does not go down suddenly. Now, here in the right side picture, a close-up of the same thermometer is taken, and you can see that in the middle is a capillary tube so that the mercury can expand inside that tube. On either side of this tube are two scales. On the side which is below the capillary tube is the Fahrenheit scale, and the other side is the centigrade scale. The part which is written in red shows the actual temperature of the body. Now, if we have to measure body temperature, then we'll use the following steps. First, wash the thermometer with water. Second, give a firm jerk to the thermometer. Third, place the bulb of thermometer below the tongue. Fourth, after 2 minutes, take the thermometer out. Then fifth, hold horizontally and read the thermometer. See the next picture. This is a picture of a laboratory thermometer. Now, a laboratory thermometer is used in a lab for experiments. Now, this laboratory thermometer is similar to that of a clinical one, except that it does not have a kink. And besides that, it has a reading from minus 10 degrees Celsius to 110 degrees Celsius. This laboratory thermometer is always kept in vertical position while noting the reading. This next picture is that of a digital thermometer. A digital thermometer is safe to use because it does not contain mercury. It contains a heat-sensitive circuit called thermistor in its tip. It has an LCD display that shows the temperature in numbers. These numbers can be in centigrade and also it can be in Fahrenheit. This thermistor is present at the tip of this thermometer and it senses the heat from the body, and then it shows the heat or the temperature of the body in this LCD screen. So this is all for today. Thank you for watching.